Hi, Paul. Hi, Damien. Hi, Loki. Hello, family. Today we have a special treat. We're going to read together a book called Grandma Ptarmigan. I hope you've had a great day and that you're snuggled in and you're ready for a story. Here we go. You ready? So this is Grandma Ptarmigan. And you can see, I can't read these words, unfortunately, these names, but this is who it's by and who it's illustrated by as well. The illustrations are absolutely beautiful. Here we go. Grandmother Ptarmigan, and they're outside their little igloo. And look, he looks so cute, all snuggled in, the little baby ptarmigan. Once there was a little ptarmigan who would not go to sleep. His grandma sang him a lullaby, but he would not go to sleep. His grandma said, "Close your eyes now." Still, he would not go to sleep. Little ptarmigan said, "Grandma, tell me a story." And grandma said, "I don't have a story to tell. Tuck in and go to sleep." And grandma, and he said, "Grandma, tell me a story." And grandma said, "I don't have a story to tell. Tuck in and go to sleep." Again, he said, "Grandma, please tell me a story." It's a very insistent little guy. And so grandma told her little ptarmigan a story, so he would stop asking. "See over there in the porch, there are baby lemmings with no hair. They want to come over here and get warm." And the little ptarmigan started to squirm. "Ooh. They want to crawl up your back, under your armpits, around your neck. They want to crawl inside." The little ptarmigan squirmed even more. "Bah!" And do you see the cat shadow? Wonder who that is. "Oh no, here they come." And with that, grandma tickled her little ptarmigan here, there, and everywhere. And the little ptarmigan shook with fright. And then that little ptarmigan, who had never flown before, jumped up and flew away. "Oh, my poor frightened little grandson has flown away," grandma cried. "Knock, knock. Where did he go? Where did he go?" grandma cried. "Knock, knock. Oh, my poor frightened little grandson has flown away." Once there was a little ptarmigan who would not go to sleep, and that is why baby ptarmigans fly so young, and that is why female ptarmigans cry, knock, knock. And Rhonda wanted to hear the story too. And there is your story for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll post this as a separate document so that you can read along without me reading with you. So maybe you can figure out the words as you go. All right. We'll talk to you soon. It was fun. Love you. Bye.